Hello, welcome to Lichens of India channel. Today we are at the heart of Western Ghats. We are in a place called Kalinga Mane. Otherwise it is known as Kalinga Center for Rainforest Ecology. This is located in the Agumbe in a Gudekeri area. I am here with my friend Prashant. We will be entering into their territory and also into a evergreen forest to explore the lichens of this area as well as to know about the Kalinga Center for Rainforest Research. Now we are deep in the evergreen forest of Kalinga Mane, a research station here. So this is a typical example of thick undisturbed evergreen forest. You can see the big tree backside here, the buttress root tree. You can see the typical trees of evergreen forest, and on the right side here you can see a riparian stream here. And you can see this vegetation typical to this area.
So in this forest, we have with us Mr. Prashant from KCRE, Kalinga Center for Rainforest Ecology. And this forest is in the proximity of Kalinga Mane, which is a field station, wildlife campsite for this area. And this organization is headed by Dr. Gauri Shankar. And so we'll also try to understand that why this organization was set up here and what are the main activities or the objectives of this organization in this place?
So generally this is a wildlife campsite. So we give education whoever comes here, whoever interested in wildlife. So we give like a little whatever availability of timing, we give education for them. Maybe frogs, snakes, plants, whatever. So the basic facility we are giving whoever comes here.
And what was the main objective behind choosing this particular area as the campsite or as the base for the organization? Why is this area so important?
Because this is away from the human habitat. Around 2 kilometer radius, we don't have any houses here. Because if we have any closer houses, we have like maybe interruption with the locals, things like that. And yeah, this is good, nice place.
And also we have heard a lot about this area being a very rich habitat for the cobra, especially the king cobra. So can you just give a little information about that?
Yeah, king cobras are there all over the Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. But we are working here last 10-12 years. So that's why people know so king cobras are more here. It's not like that. King cobras are there throughout the Western Ghats. Yeah.
Sometimes if we find such type of trees, they are fallen, we can collect lichens up to their twig. So such type of trees are good for collection of lichens because we are getting lichens starting from its base up to the trunk. Here you can see again, it's a very moist condition over here. You will see these patches. All these patches, they belong to Thelotomataceae. On the other side, if you see this side, which is facing the stream, you have Phyllopsora species. You can see here growing Phyllopsora patches. Here, this Phyllopsora is growing luxuriantly over here. Again, this trunk is laden with all Porina species. Here again you can see that it is one Pinocarpus lichen which is growing on this trunk. It is again covered with some Protosaria, Thelotrima upstairs. If you see at the down, it's Oscillaria or again Thelotrimataceae. So such type of habitat and tree trunks, they provide excellent habitat or excellent substrate to Thelotrimata lichens to colonize. This whole patch, you can see the luxuriant growth of some basidio Basidia lichen. Basidia is, its whole trunk is covered with this species, and you can see black apothecia there. This is one of the common palm in this place, and you can see that it is covered with the epiphytic lichens and mosses. Mostly the epiphytic or folliculous lichens are growing on these palms. This is again a good habitat of folliculous lichens over here. On the pillars, you can see the growth of, luxuriant growth of lichens. These all are green patches of poraina. Because it's a very moist condition, when the seam is there, so whatever substratum is available to lichens, they colonize over there. This is poraina, which is colonizing on a rocky structure. You can see that it is pored structure, okay, Gaurav?
Yes.
It is pored structure,
yeah.
And these pores, they are sunken in the thallus, and pores are small. It appears that it may be myotrema, that thylotrematous genera.
We are again collecting the lichens, yeah, from this evergreen forest patch near the Gudde Keri, where we had entered. So now, Dr. Gaurav, can you just give me a brief idea about what we are collecting?
Yeah, actually, I have seen some patch of the poraina lichens, Paranocarpus lichens. Here you can see the whole trunk with the laden from the Paranocarpus lichens, especially from the poraina. So we are just collecting the poraina species from here.
And why is this poraina so important, and why does it grow in this habitat? Any specific reason?
Yeah. Actually, this type of communities are indicate that this forest is the evergreen forest and near to the streams. That's why this species is growing luxuriantly. Here you can see in this trunk are another trees. You will find Paranocarpus lichens along with the thylotrematoid lichens. That's why I am collecting this patch for this crustose lichens to identification. And rather than this, I want to do also collect from the some cyanolichens also.
Okay.
And these lichens also indicate for the forest type, which type of
so all these three groups, the Paranocarpus, the thylotrematoids, as well as the porinaceous lichens, indicate this humid, moist, evergreen forest nature.
Yeah.
And that's why they are found in plenty in the Western Ghats, especially.
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay.
Beautiful tree with a lot of lichen patches. Big, huge tree with the buttress root. You can see several lichen patch here. Similar kind of patch I'm seeing here. This is Phyllopsora patch, and here we have Cococarpia. This is Leptogium, and this is Pyranocarpus lichens here. Beautiful lichen patch here. Several lichens on one single tree. See this tree, big tree with numerous buttress roots here. And on this tree, you can see white patches here. These white patches are lichens, a crustose lichen, especially belonging to genus Hemitetium. Of course, now the graphitaceous classification has changed. And very luxuriant growth of Hemitetium on this tree bark. And graphitaceous lichens are the other major group of lichens, along with thylotremataceous and Pyranocarpus lichens in the evergreen forest. So, beautiful example of graphitaceous lichen here in these trees. Again, this tree, this is a woody climber you see here going on. This is again a characteristic of evergreen forest. And on this woody climber, you see white patches here. This is a luxuriant growth of thylotremataceous lichen here. You can see beautiful material here. As I told you earlier, this is again a characteristic of evergreen forest lichen biota. Lots of bark I'm collecting here.
Without harming tree?
Yes. It doesn't harm tree. Okay. It is only growing on the dead bark.
Okay.
So whenever these cultivators, in orchards, lichens, they come and they colonize on the cultivated trees.
Mm-hmm.
So these farmers or the cultivators, they think that, oh, it will destroy my orchard. But it doesn't destroy their orchard. It only grows on the outer dead bark. But sometimes it provides a place or a habitat, a house to the insects to come and live inside.
Alright, so Prashant, you have been with us in this journey. You have seen the lichens as we have collected it from this forest. Yes. But before this, have you ever noticed lichens in the forest, or have you ever looked into it, or have you ever discussed it with somebody, or what is your take on the lichens?
No, I've seen patches in the trees. I know there are lichens, but I don't know any, I can't ID it. But in monsoon time, we used to see bioluminescent lichens. That I know, because whenever you go for a walk, we used to see that the other bioluminescence glows in the night. That pretty much.
Apart from the cobra varieties, what are the other snake species that are found in this area?
So we have almost 35 species of snakes here, like pit vipers, and we have crate and cat snake. So many varieties of snakes.
And what are the other wildlife that is found in this forest?
We have gaur, and we have leopard and wild dog, wild boar, sambar deer, mouse deer, barking deer, and civet. We have otter also here.
Okay.
Yeah, we have pretty good wildlife here.
So what about the people that are coming here to this campsite, to this forest site? What are they interested in most? Are they interested in the plants? Are they interested in the wildlife? What is the overall interest of the people that who come here?
People come like varieties. Like some people like plants, some people like frogs, some people like macro, like insects. So many people, they have different kind of interests.
So can you just tell our people very briefly that if somebody wants to visit this campsite and stay at this place and experience the overall nature of this region, how do they contact you? How do they approach you?
So you can contact us like KCRE, like Kalinga Center for Rainforest Ecology. You can Google it, you'll get the email ID, whatever numbers. Yeah, they can call us directly also.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much, Mr. Prashant. It was
nice
lovely having a discussion with you,
yeah,
especially in this beautiful forest.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, friends, for joining us on this short field trip in the beauty of the Western Ghats with Dr. DK Upreti and Dr. Sanjeeva Nayaka. If you like this video, please click like button and also subscribe our channel for more updates and notifications.